Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everyone. Let me introduce myself. My name is Rahayu Rizki Putri. The Honorable Mr. Afrizal and dear my lovely friends, all praise is due to Allah, the Almighty God, who has been giving us His mercy and blessing until we can attend this English class without any obstacle. Standing here, I would like to say about the quality of education in Indonesia. So far, we are facing many complicated problems with this topic. As we know, Indonesia students rank among the lowest countries of the world. Therefore, among the Southeast Asian countries, the quality of education in Indonesia is lower than Malaysia, Singapore, even Thailand. Do you know that Indonesia is the fourth largest educational system, but we are ranked last? And the worst, people were shocked by the failure of many students on the last final exam. Then, a big question arises to all of us. Are Indonesian students really weak to apply knowledge and skills to tasks that are relevant to their future life? Perhaps it must be wrong to judge the conclusion, but this question is always supported by the factual situation that the outcome is not good. There were many students at senior or junior high school who failed on the final exam. This situation is getting worse since many companies are interested to Indonesian students from the abroad only. Then, on the other hand, there are state and private universities in Indonesia which force the students to pay the highest cost. They don't let poor students to study there, although they are clever. Every student has paid at least 20 million for the school fee. It means that good education is the expensive thing to pay. We can't imagine that any opportunities to study just for the rich people. The eyes for this problem. Dear audiences, with the problem facing both, how to overcome this problem? We have to push a better educational system with the support of the school, teacher, government, and civil society at large. They have to work together to improve the quality of education better. Because without any support from all, it means nothing. Besides that, the government can help cost for education. They also have to give chance to the teacher to take some courses to improve their qualities. Moreover, the government has to improve the quality of education itself. They can give assessment focused on how well students apply their knowledge and skills. We have to know the strength and weakness of the student because applying knowledge and skills are more important rather than on the memorization of the subject matter knowledge. If all children in Indonesia get a qualified education, Indonesia will have qualified human resources who are ready to build the nation. Hopefully, because education provides the most universal key to a new world and better life, we can manage and lead up everything to be better life by qualified education. That's all my speech. I wanna take quotes from Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein once said, "Everyone was a genius, but if you judge a fish by its way to climb a tree, then it will live a whole life to say that is stupid." Then, for example, B.J. Habibie is a son from Indonesia. He found the crack progress for the world. That's absolutely amazing. Then, that's all that I can say. Thank you very much for your attention. I'm sorry if I have mistake because we are human. Then, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.